What will happen if the heavenly principles finally awaken? One thing for sure, there will be a war. But fear not, there are at least for now two non-factions who have prepared for the last 500 years for this definite moment, Fatui and the Abyss Order. So how do these two factions resolve this and save the entire Teyvat? From the information we have till this moment, version 4.7, there are two major plans that have already been prepared. Fatui with their action of collecting Genosis, and the Abyss Order with their Loom of Fate operation. Although this statement seems to imply that both parties are working together, in reality, at least for now, they seem to not. But I believe there is a pretty high chance both parties will collaborate. To know how and why, let's focus back on their respective plans. The first thing we need to address here is the opponent, the Heavenly Principles. This is very important because in battle, we need to know at the very least what our opponent is, then we can make a proper strategy against it. The Heavenly Principles consists of two things, the Unknown God and Heavenly Principle itself. Heavenly Principle is a system or set of rules built from a collection of people's will that produce fate, while the Unknown God is the one who does what is prescribed by the system or rules, basically sustaining it. If you want to know the reason behind this, you can watch my video about it later, link in the description down below. So, since the Unknown God is also under the influence of the system, the sufficient way to fight against the whole thing is to take down the system itself. There are two components here that need to be considered, namely the will and the product of it, the fate. And luckily enough, our two factions seem to aim for that thing. As we already know together from the Winter Night Lazo trailer, Fatui already declared to seize the authority from the gods, especially the theme about burning the old world and create new one. By taking Genosis, Fatui almost accomplished one component. But why choose Genosis specifically? We need to remember, aside from the symbol of God's authority, Genosis, based on Fontaine Archon Quest, is also the remains of the Third Descender. One might argue this remains means the material thing, but if we see it from another perspective, it could mean that what remains could actually be the will of the Third Descender. That explains why Genosis is really compatible with and can enhance its respective element, can hold their user ambition and obsession, could open the realm of consciousness, and fit with the rest of Teyvat, similar to our traveler, the Fourth Descender. The next question is, how would Fatui utilize it? There are three major speculations. Number one, to revive the Third Descender. Whether it means reviving the physical body or just bring back the consciousness of that will still can be debatable. Number two, put it into some kind of unique machine. Or number three, they prepare it so that the traveler at the end can make use of it. But since we don't have any further info about that, this will remain a mystery. Regardless of what they would choose, essentially, the gathering of all Genosis is to revolve that one component, the will that resides in Heavenly Principles. Alongside that, Fatui has several side projects that are no less important, such as Project Stugia, the Fabrication of Delusion, and most importantly, the old project that had and is currently conducting by Dottore, including that one memorial scene, the burning Ilminsu. From here, we can see pretty clearly that Fatui is really focusing on burning the old world first. I don't know about you, but I feel Fatui is lacking one thing. How do they plan to create a new world, or rather recover it? Plus, there is still one component left that needs to be touched, the fate. And so, here's where the Abyss Order takes the stage. Although at the beginning of the game, the Abyss Order seems to have many operations on its hand, in fact, after the new Archon Quest bedtime story, we can certainly confirm that the Loom of Fate is their spear point. Then, What is the loom of fate? And what makes it so great that it can revolve the fate? Here's what Caribet had to say.
As for your question, the loom of fate is a device capable of weaving ley lines. In its primitive form, it can only be used to create and implant memories. But as more of it is completed, its power becomes stronger and stronger, until finally, it has the power to weave real ley lines of its own. Once fully completed, the moment it gains the power to weave ley lines, it loses the lower level ability to influence memories, but it also becomes a tool that can change the entire world.
So what does he mean? From my understanding, basically it means the Loom of Fate, to a certain extent, is a mimic or a replica of the current Teyvat Leyline system. And since Leyline are connected to the Fate, then the Loom of Fate is a perfect match against it. By using it, in theory, the Abyss Order could influence the real Leyline or even potentially create new reality. But there is one thing that need to remember. Teyvat Leyline cannot be replaced, in a sense of copy-paste on top of it, nor extended, which means there is a possibility we need to transfer everything from Teyvat Leyline into the new one in order to save everyone. It sounds like a really good idea. Aside from how we do that, we also need to consider, after the transfer, how can we make sure that nobody will abuse the new ley lines? I guess until it happened, this could be another topic to discuss. As we have discussed, both factions are lacking one component. Fatui needs a tool for the fate, while the Abyss Order needs the will. There are three scenarios here I would love to propose. The first one is the most optimistic. Both parties would collaborate with each other. This might sound less convincing, but hear me out for a second. We already know that the founder and most of the members of the Abyss Order came from Kanria. Then there is one person who we also know came from Kanria and even became a director for the Fatui. And that person, none other than Piero the Jester himself. I feel like there could be a connection between the Jester and the Abyss Order. Perhaps Piero was a member of the Abyss Order, or he built the Fatui as a side operation, or because of where he came from, Piero could negotiate with them. Aside from that, without any conspiracies, they could just team up for the sake of a common enemy. The second scenario is more straightforward. They will fight each other to get another piece of the puzzle. And as to who will win, I will leave you to speculate. Lastly, the third scenario. This one is quite interesting because it involves the Traveler. From the very beginning, the Traveler is labeled as the unknown variable and the witness. This means that even though both components have been collected, it still needs another component to work perfectly. And the key lies with the Traveler. Perhaps Traveler's will and memories are the only thing that can restore Teyvat after everything would happen. As Denslip said in Teyvat chapter storyline,
"Then the threads of all fate will be yours to reweave."
And that's it. With the combination of those two plans, we will have the ultimate project. The one that can save and escape everybody from the fateful prison. But on the other hand, surely this plan is not that easy, right? Because we still don't know the purpose of other factions, such as the Hexen Circle and the Five Sinners, nor the Heavenly Principles' motives. So what do you think? Is the collaboration between those two factions possible? Do Hexen Circle and the Five Sinners also contribute to this, or perhaps all this thing is somewhat meaningless? Share your opinion and ideas in the comment section down below. Don't forget to leave like and subscribe. Thank you for all the support. Hello Zen here, and see you next time. Bye.